Hi everybody, and welcome to another SciCraft episode. In this episode, I want to finish the double zombie spawner mob switch project. The last two episodes, we dug a tunnel from spawn up to this point, which is about 4,000 blocks away, built the instant repeater line, and built the redstone logic at spawn, and also built the redstone logic here at the double zombie spawner. There's something I added in between the episodes, and this was a slight oversight. So in case we restart the server and we would need to reload the hoppers again, the existing redstone wouldn't do that. That's why I just added another redstone dust line with instant repeaters just to load all of those chunks again just for once, and then all the changes we do at this part would take effect later. It's just a little oversight in case something like this would ever happen, then this would be fixed with this extra line there. Alright, now the next thing I want to work on is the actual the zombie chambers and the spawner system. So the plan is just to collect all the zombies, sort out the baby zombies, and then put 140 zombies each in cells in different chunk. So this, we have in total 4 chunks here in a row. So in each chunk, I will put 140 zombies. Now, I could either do it manually or come up with an automatic system. The automatic system would have the advantage that it's quite convenient. Also, in case something goes wrong, we despawn the zombies by accident, we could just run the system again and don't need to do it manually again. Those are the advantages. Of course, it would be a lot easier just to put 140 in there manually. So as always, I switch to a creative world in order to figure this out, because it's not that easy. So we basically have two options: to put 140 mobs in one cell and then basically seal it off and then send all the zombies to the next cell. The first one would be to use a pressure plate, and the second option would be to use a counter. I actually prefer the pressure plate because it's quite simple, but it has some issues, mostly the max entity cramming rule. So I set the rule to max entity cramming 3. If we put a fourth zombie in there, they would get damaged, and this obviously doesn't work. But there's a little workaround you could do. If you place a ladder or vines at the foot level of the zombies, then they don't collide, and that means the zombie egg-pack, that means they don't get damaged by the max entity cramming. So this was first shown by Pi. So 3 and the 4th one, and I can continue to put zombies in there. But obviously this is a bit of a problem, because I can't put a pressure plate and vines or ladders in the same block. So we have to come up with something. So this is one solution for a problem, because you could get the ladder effect from a certain distance. So you could stand on the pressure plate and still get the ladder effect. So the max distance I tested was a fence. The cobble wall, you're already standing too far away. So if we would somehow get the zombies in here, this would be perfect. Could actually also limit it, because they shouldn't have the ability to go to the right of the iron pressure plate. So we just need to drop them in here, and then they're nicely sealed off. They don't get damaged by anti-cramming, since the ladder effect applies. And they're standing on the iron pressure plate. So when we get 141 mobs in there, we would get a single strength of 15. And you could just detect it, for example, by using a comparator. And once we are above 14, then this would turn on. So something like this could work. A water stream on top that just puts in the zombies from above. So this definitely works. The max entity cramming is still set to 3. But as it turns out, the system has a few flaws, so at the moment it still looks fine. But the problem with this one is that I've seen the zombies taking damage when they fall down. And there's another issue, they could actually climb up the ladder like I could. It's probably hard to demonstrate it. Maybe if I get a villager so they start the pathfinding, if they can, then they would actually go up the ladder, which is a bit of an issue. You can see now they would climb up, and then they all get killed by Entity cramming. I'm also quite sure if I would completely seal this off, they would still start to pathfind at some point, because I saw it already. So this way probably doesn't work. We could maybe try a workaround, so we could put a trapdoor on top, which would prevent the zombies from climbing up the ladders, but we would need to open it in order to let the other zombies fall down. So a zero tick doesn't work, it's not long enough. So the shortest pulse you can give would be a one game tick pulse. Yes, this would cause them to fall through. I think I'm just gonna test this out with 140 zombies and then we'll see if this is an option. So this doesn't look good at all at the moment, so they somehow don't go down. Let's try this again. Yeah, now they're all up. So even if I just use a one game tick pulse, they still would be able to climb up the ladders. That is definitely not an option to drop them in from the top. So I talked a bit with Methods and he showed me a contraption that he used for a villager system. So instead of dropping them in from the top, you could also just push them in from the side and then seal it off again. So if I'm gonna drop in an entity in here, those pistons here would reject and then would be pushed by this piston into this spot. Since it's off the pressure plate again, the pistons would extend again and then the zombie is pushed over into the cell here. So this could actually be something we could consider using. So this looks quite promising. It also works with the vines here. Just need to find a way now to get them on top of a pressure plate as well. Okay, so this is just an idea, but it doesn't seem to work to use a villager. So the idea was that they would pathfind towards the villager, but yeah. Oh yeah, this is also a problem, baby zombies. We have to filter them out first of all. But seems like the pathfinding doesn't work and they would try to take a, not the direct route. Might be a way to fix this, but also the whole idea seems unreliable in the first place. I mean, they aren't held back, so there's always something that could go wrong. Really need to force them in between two blocks like this so they can't move at all. So I don't think using AI would be the solution for this problem here, to get them to stand on basically both blocks. So what we should also avoid at any cost is the zombies dying, because this would be a huge problem. Because they would drop their rotten flesh and another zombie would pick it up and no longer count towards the mob cap. Now, we really rely that we got 140 zombies in here. If you would have just 139, then for example, if you rely on having 5 mob caps, we would have 4 mob caps and change. And then we still got some mobs spawning. And we really want to rely on our mob switches. We can't accept that there's still a possibility the creeper spawns and blows up our really huge and complex flying machines. So we have to avoid this at all costs that any mobs, one of those mobs dies. So we need to make this safe somehow. After a bit of tinkering around, we came up with another idea. So that's this one here. So the idea is that we would limit the zombies with the fence gate here and the cobble wall here. And here's the ladder, and they also stand on the iron pressure plate. Now the zombies would be dropped in from on top, and then we extend the sticky piston with the slime blocks. And this fence gate also would be powered, so it opens. Then we just retract all of those slime blocks. The zombie is trapped in there, in the slime blocks. And then he gets some momentum, like usual if you push him up with a slime block. And since the fence gate is also open, he can go through it. And then once it's all retracted, we close the fence gate again. And the zombie should be trapped with the others. Like this. Now there's a little bit of a problem. Okay. We really have to sort out those baby zombies, just using a normal egg at the moment. There's a bit of a problem, which is the ladder. Because if they would start pathfinding, they could actually, since the ladder has collision box, which can't be passed, so if the zombie's not directly in the center of the block, the ladder could be in the way and then it would get stuck. So there's a bit of an issue. So if you would also flush them in with a water stream from the top, so maybe from here, then it would be kind of pushed against this block here, and then they fall down, and then they are, yeah, a bit on the right, and then they collide with the ladder and kind of go through there, and then they would suffocate inside of the slime blocks. The vine would be the ideal solution. Oops. Yeah, we also have to close this, I guess. Also, this probably wasn't the smartest idea to build this next to a village, since they start pathfinding all the time. Yeah, anyway, so the vine would be the ideal solution, since it doesn't have this collision box. So you could walk up to the block. So it's the best way to show this, I guess. If you look at the F3 screen, the set value 2816.3, and same for the vine, 2816.3. But with the ladder, it's a bit different. So if you try to get close to it, you count this 0.488. So as you can see, the vine doesn't have the collision, but the ladder does. But unfortunately, we can't use the vine. Because this is a 1.12 bug, you can't put vines under fence gates for some reason. So this would have worked in 1.11, but yeah, they messed around with vines basically in 1.11, and this is broken at the moment. So we can't use a vine here, so we have to come up with something. It seems like the trapdoor will be the solution, because it also adds 0.188 blocks, like the ladder. So we could probably use the trapdoor in order to align the zombies somehow. So we could maybe put a trapdoor in here. So this would already align them. We also need one at the top, where they could fall down. But then we probably also need one here somehow limiting it. Okay, so we can't first of all use a pressure plate. That'd be an issue. Okay, we definitely need another trapdoor here, but this one will be picked up by the slime block. So the issue would be, yeah, so basically you need a trapdoor every second block, because if you have something like this, then it's always how it goes, they could glitch in there somehow. So we wouldn't need one here. But if I would try to do this, then I would pick up the trapdoor. So I would need to put it back each time. And in between it can probably also fall down at the same time. And yeah, we have to come up with something else. Probably move the slime block to the side. Alright, it seems like we have a working zombie holding cell that also counts to 140. So we can put in a few. So they would activate the tripwire here, which in turn, you have just a monostable, activates the slime block pushing, and then the zombies are put into the holding cell, where they can't escape since they're limited by the cobble wall and the fence gate. So this works really reliable. Let's do a little stress test. Okay, so they apparently could get stuck in here. There's some pathfinding. That's probably that village over there. Guess if I kill all the villagers, then this should actually fix the issue. So we just have to make sure that there's no villager nearby. Villager. There we go. I should also calm them down with the pathfinding. Yeah, now it looks really good. Alright, so there's one last thing we need before the holding cells. It's the baby zombie sorter or filter. So you can see the normal zombies would go up the mob elevator, but the baby zombies, they are not tall enough, they can't reach the other water source, and it would just get flushed down to the side here. So it's quite simple. Also works 100% reliable as far as I can tell, because the normal zombies, they are too tall, they would be blocked by this glass block here. They can't go to the right. And I've never seen a baby zombie going up a mob elevator, so that doesn't happen at all. What's also kind of important is that you have a cobble wall here at the bottom. If you would have a normal block instead, and baby zombies could be caught in here. But since this is a half a block higher, they're always inside of a water stream, and there's no chance they would ever stop. Alright, so we just need to put this at the output of the two mob spawners, and then before the holding cells, and then this would be hooked up to this water stream more or less. Alright, I think we got all the components, now we can actually build this up in survival. Alright, so the room is now completely finished. We actually built this up during a live stream. Some people probably already know about this room, but we really needed this mob switch in order to work on some other projects. So yeah, some people probably already got spoiled by the live stream. Alright, I think in the end it looks quite decent. It's kind of a shame that if everything works out as intended, we'll probably never go here again, but it's kind of nice to spend a little bit of time on making things look decent. Of course, we're no professional builders, but it's better than an iron room, which we had before. Alright, now let's check this out. So I put a bot there, which enables the mob spawner. We put some redstone lamps on top, so he's standing on pressure plates in case. Why is there a mob? Did one of those mobs escape? I will have to investigate. So in case he's standing on the pressure plates, then the redstone lamps will be turned off. Then they're flushed over to a single spot, and then they go up the item elevator slash baby zombie filter, and they will be put into the holding cells. Alright, we already have quite a bunch in there. And there's something I haven't shown yet, so in case this comparator here reaches signal string 15, then those two redstone lamps turn on, indicating that we have filled up a chamber, and this dispenser top will be activated. So then the water is flushed, is flushing the mobs further, they won't fall in the gap anymore, and they will be transferred to the second holding chamber and so on. So if all four holding cells are filled up with zombies, then this is the overflow, they all go into lava afterwards. So what's also important is if you're standing on the AFK spot that you're not further away than 32 blocks from the zombies so they don't despawn. And also the portal should be within 32 blocks of each zombie when you want to leave the area. Alright, I guess we can actually try this out. So I got some zombies in there. Now let's leave through a portal and see if they're still there if I'm coming back. Alright, now let's check this out. Because sometimes there's a problem with the portal method. Yeah, here. Zombies despawned. I was kind of expecting it already. Probably need to move the portal. I don't completely understand what's going on there, but I had this issue before. I think if you just build the portal somewhere else, it might fix this problem. Alright, I've done some investigating, and I think the position of the portal isn't actually that important. It's something else that causes them to despawn. Now, if you leave through a portal, some of the chunks are not immediately unloaded in the overworld. We have the carpet mod running on survival, so you can actually check this. So there's still 340 chunks loaded back at this position in the overworld, so it's 4000 minus 600 approximately. Now, I'm quite sure if you would go through the portal again, you're first put at the corresponding positions in the overworld. So the nether positions, I will be put to 500 minus 76 in the overworld first. In the next tick, I will be teleported to the actual positions in the overworld. So just by multiplying it by 8. And if those chunks are still loaded and entity processing, in the one tick, I'm at the other coordinates in the overworld, the mobs would despawn. So my theory is, so I haven't tested this yet, if I would wait until those chunks are unloaded, so this means we have to do this while no permaloader is active, then the zombies should still be there. Okay, now let's see. Be really disappointed if that's not the case. And here they are. Okay, so in order to do this, you need to wait for those chunks to be unloaded and then you can go back there again. So I noticed another minor issue that sometimes could happen, that a zombie doesn't pass the fence gate. Like, saw there, glitched a little bit through it, and then he got stuck in front of the fence gate, like this one here. Okay, and then we had the issue that those zombies didn't get, or they would suffocate inside of the slime blocks, like this one here. So we need to come up with a solution for that. I already tried ice below, but it doesn't seem to fix it completely. So the system is a little bit flawed. I'm not sure what we could do here. Alright, so I could not fix the issue. That's how it goes sometimes. I actually tried a lot, different ideas, and in the end, nothing really worked. And if you can't fix an issue, you just have to work around it. So the problem was that the zombie would suffocate if he glitched into that position here. Not just by rebuilding this a little bit, we don't have the slime block on top anymore. We just have the slime block at the bottom. Now it could happen that we have a zombie standing in here, but this is not a big deal because the issue kind of fixes itself, I hope. So now we have two in there, let's see what happens if another one comes in. So just hope that over time they would either just stand around here and do nothing, or the problem fixes itself. So where's the next batch? Okay, it's gonna take a little bit of while. Okay, we still have two in there. Okay, now one ran out. Let's see what happens. Okay, still two. Okay, Okay. But I guess as long as it's not like 20, then this shouldn't be an issue at all. Let's see if it gets worse. Alright, so the first zombie chamber is completely filled up. The dispenser was activated. And at worst, there were three zombies here inside of the slime blocks. At the end, there was just one left. It's a bit random what happens. So I don't think that's actually a deal breaker, a big issue at all. Of course, it's not really pretty. It would be better if it would work 100% reliable and all the zombies would be put into that box, but I guess I can live with this. So this is the moment of truth. All four cells are completely filled up. Zombies are already going to the overflow. I can also step off the pressure plates. And now we can go back to the Nether, and I hope that nothing here despawns, but they shouldn't. I'm also alone on the server now, so definitely should work. Just gonna wait until they're also out of the water streams here. Okay, now we can check again. Unload overworld. Yeah, so there are 450 chunks still loaded, all in that area mostly. Okay, just gonna wait. Or I could actually go to spawn and wait until all the chunks are unloaded. So now it says that all the chunks are unloaded except some chunks that I'm already hopper loading. So if you go to spawn, we can actually check for the mob cap. So we should have 210 shulkers plus 140 and change wizards. So we can check this by just doing the spawn mob cap command, which is also part of the carpet mod, and we have 500 monsters. So 280 or 290 plus 210. Perfect. So this is actually enough for 7 players. So 3 mob caps in the tower, oops, and 4 mob caps from the extra mob switch. Now let's crank it up to 11 mob caps. Just have to wait a little bit. About 10 seconds. Can already see again. And there we have it. 922 mobs. And it should be 11 times 70. We actually have a lot more mobs. Maybe there were some lazy chunks on the way. Yeah, anyway. The last thing I want to test is actually to turn this off and see if we have 210 again. But this could probably take a while until all the chunks unload with the autosave cycle. So I'll get back to you. Alright, so it did take a while until all the chunks got unloaded. But now we're back to 211 monsters. And I can, activate the mob switch whenever I want to. Perfect. This was desperately needed, and now we can focus on another project again. Alright, so this was the final episode on the mob switch. Thanks a lot for watching. Have a nice day. Bye bye.